first of all, please see that we are not talking imaginary stuff here. Given the way we are, can we let our kids live without expectation? We expect value even from half a rupee that we spent. That's how we are. But you are saying, if we let the child be free, is there anybody that we can let free? Is there anybody we may not expect anything from? Do you know what it requires to let anybody free? Do you know what it requires to not to expect in relationship? You are saying as if it is a choice, as if you can do that remaining what you are. So you are saying, no, it is possible, I can do it, it is within my control, I just have to flip a switch or push a button, but you know, I'm not doing it. Do you have it in you to do that, first of all? Do you have it to let the loved one fly free? Do you have it to not to expect anything? Do you have it not to be greedy in a relationship? Do you have it to give without asking for returns? But we don't look at that. We say, you see, if I do that, then it won't be right. The question is not about if you do that. The question is, can you do that? Given what you are, can you do that? But look at the misplaced confidence. Oh, of course I can do that. Of course. I'm just not doing it because it's not right. Of course I can do this. Of course. Try giving even 1 rupee to a beggar without expecting gratitude. Try. It's not so much about the kid. It's about you. If you are right, then most of these questions themselves would vanish. Your obligation is not to expect. That is your compulsion. That is your inner compulsion. To expect. How do you like it when people demand returns from you? Do you feel loving towards them? Yes? Is this not obvious? Someone serves you a glass of water, right? And then serves you the bill. Do you give him "I love you" in return? Yes? What are you talking? And then you are using words like ancient tradition, soul, masters, new humanity. Why don't you simply talk of a fearful mind? But that's what our condition is, right? Look at the whole mass, the whole crowd of words being tossed. This soul, that soul, what soul, where soul? Just say, "I'm afraid." Then that is sufficient. No, not at all. You very well know what you are doing. You may name it as love, but somewhere you very well know that it is all deception. And the proof of that is that you run away when that deception is about to be exposed. Had you really been confident that what you are exhibiting is love, then you would have stood for it. Then you would have confidently faced any questions about it, but you don't face them. Whenever questions are raised, you repress those questions, and that proves that you know that you are living in the false. You are afraid that the falseness might be exposed, so you avoid those occasions and those people who question your ways. You dislike them, don't you? And it's a very popular excuse, don't fall to it, that you know his or her intentions are loving. It is just that the fellow is not very aware, but his intentions are good. No way. The intentions have been named as good. They are not good. Nothing except the truth is good. Just because you name something as love, it does not become love. You may tout it as love. You may sell it as love. It does not become love.